We're taking a look at the Koch curve now. You should have just watched a video about this Koch curve and learned that this is another example of a fractal design. And in the video, they created they didn't just take a line, but they created a whole like snowflake type of figure. We're just going to look at just like one side of that snowflake. So we're going to be generating this a little bit differently than what we saw in the video. And what we're going to do is we're going to use fractions and exponents to help describe the length of each side of this Koch curve or Koch snowflake. So first thing we want to do is take a look at how we're moving from stage to stage. This one's a little bit trickier than that Sierpinski triangle or some of the other fractal designs we've looked at. So I'm going to walk through it with you. But basically, what happens when we move from stage to stage is we take one side. That looks really ugly. So we take one side, we take one segment, and we end up splitting it into four segments. Okay, so we took this one segment here in stage zero and we split it up into one, two, three, four segments in stage one. Okay, and the way that we did that is we took this one segment and then what we do is we split it into thirds, split it into thirds, and then create an equilateral triangle in that center piece. Create an equilateral triangle. Equilateral meaning that all three sides of that triangle would be the same, right? And then we basically just like erase out this center piece. And that's how we go from stage zero to stage one. And then from stage one to stage two, we do the same exact thing on all four of the segments. So see how on this first segment right here, what we did to get from stage one to stage two is we split that segment into thirds, created an equilateral triangle, and then basically erased out that bottom piece. Okay? So that's kind of how we're creating it. Don't worry too much if you're not following it perfectly. The important piece, what we're really looking at, is the length of the sides. Okay? So the length of the sides. So we start out assuming that at stage one, the length of that segment is one. And then, like I said, to go from stage zero to stage one, we split this first line segment into thirds. So that would mean that this first segment and this last segment would be one third, because it's one third of one. And then creating an equilateral triangle here, well, that would mean that each side of that triangle would also be one third. And then taking out that middle bottom piece, we end up with what we have over here in stage one. Each segment has a length of one third. Okay, each segment has a length of one third in stage one. And then moving on to stage two, we're going to use that same exact pattern, that recursive procedure to get from stage one to stage two. And that would mean that each of these segments would become one third of this segment, right? So think back, this is two lessons ago now. What we're going to do is we're going to take one third of one third. One third of one third. And can you tell me what operation does of always mean? What does of always mean in math language? Yeah, exactly. It is multiplication. And what do we do when we're multiplying with fractions? What do we do when we multiply with fractions? Yeah, we just multiply across the top, across the bottom. So 1 times 1, that equals 1. 3 times 3, that equals 9. So the length of one of these little segments in stage 2 is going to be 1/9. Okay? So 1/9. Let's change that. That's confusing. We should change that to 1/9. 1/9. Now, what we're going to do in step 1 is complete this table. So what we've got over here is our stage numbers. So we're looking for at stages 0 through 3. And at each stage, what we're going to do is we're going to count the number of segments, and then we're going to write down the length of each segment, okay? And then find the total length in fraction form and in decimal form. We're going to do that together. So first thing I'm going to do is just going to erase some of this stuff so we have a little clearer understanding of what we're starting with, right? Okay. And here we go. So we're looking at stage 0. Well, the number of segments at stage 0 is just 1. It's just 1. And then the length of each segment, the length of that one segment is 1. So the total length is going to be this times this. So 1 times 1, that just gets us 1. And 1 in fraction form is 1, 1 in decimal form is 1. Really simple for that first stage, for the zeroth stage, I should say. And then when we move on to stage 1, again, like I said, the design went from one line segment to 1, 2, 3, 4 line segments. And the length of each segment is 1/3. 1/3. So now to find the total length, I need to multiply number of segments times the length of each segment. So that's going to be 4 times 1/3, 4 times 1/3. And remember, we can rewrite a whole number as a fraction by just putting it over 1. So that's 4/1 times 1/3. And remember, we multiply across the top, multiply across the bottom. 4 times 1 is 4. 1 times 3 is 3. So the total length is 4/3. 4/3. And now we will go ahead and figure this out, put this in decimal form. Remember how to do that? Remember how to convert? That's not something I want to include, so take that piece out. Okay, so in order to convert something from fraction form to decimal form, what we need to do, all we need to do, is just type in this fraction as a division problem. Remember, all fractions are just division problems. So 4/3, that's the same thing as 4/3. So we're just going to plug that right into the calculator, 4/3, and we get 1.3 repeating. So under decimal form, I'm going to put that down, 1.3, and to write that repeating, you don't have to just like write a million threes, you can just put a line over 3, and that means that we have 1.3 repeating. Let's move on and look at stage 2. So in stage 2, the number of segments, again, increased, right? So all four of those segments turned into four more segments, right? Think about that. But what we're going to do is we're going to count it up and see if we can find this pattern. So there's going to be a pattern here, right? Because we're working with fractals. So let's count it up. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So we've got 16 segments. 16 segments. And the length of each segment, remember, we calculated was 1/9. It was 1/3 of 1/3. So 1/9. Right? And then again, to find the total length, we need to multiply. We need to multiply the number of segments times the length of each segment. Okay? So that's going to be 16 times 1 over 9, or 16 over 1 times 1 over 9, right? 16 times 1 is 16. 1 times 9 is 9. So the total length in fraction form is going to be 16 over 9. And then to find the decimal, you just pull up your calculator and you plug in 16 divided by 9 gives us 1.7 repeating. 1.7 repeating. 1.7 repeating. Okay. The line just goes over the 7 because it's the 7 that's repeating. All right, now stage three. So we don't have an image, we don't have a figure for stage three, but I think we've kind of developed a pattern well enough to be able to figure out the rest of this table. Okay, so I'm going to erase some things just so we have a little bit more space to work. Come on. So let's look at first the number of segments. So the number of segments, we went from 1 to 4, 4 to 16. So if I multiply 1 times 4, I go from 1 to 4. And if I multiply 4 times 4, I'd get to 16. So it looks like the number of segments is going to be 4 to the stage number. So 4 to the 0, that equals 1. 4 to the first, that equals 4. 4 squared, that equals 16. So at stage 3, it would be 4 to the third, or 4 cubed, which is 4 cubed is 64. 64. There's going to be 64 segments at stage 3. And remember, here, the length of each segment, we're multiplying by 1/3. So we took 1 and then we multiplied it by 1/3, which gave us 1/3. And then we took 1/3 and multiplied it by 1/3, which gave us 1/9. And now we're going to take 1/9 and multiply it by 1/3, which would give us, multiply across the top and across the bottom, 1 times 1 is 1. 9 times 3 is 27. So 1/27 would be the length of each segment in the third stage. And then again, to find the total length, we need to multiply the number of segments by the length of each segment. So in stage 3, it would be 64 times 1 over 27, or 64 over 1 times 1 over 27. 64 times 1 is 64. 1 times 27 is 27. So the total length in fraction form would be 64 over 27. And then as a decimal, again, every fraction is just a division problem. So we just take 64 and divide it by 27, which equals 2.37. 2.37. Right? And that takes care of that.